Regular viewers will know we love the Suzuki DR650. We have jumped it, wheelied it, thrashed it, and made all sorts of wild claims about it. Some viewers have told me they bought a DR650 based on our videos, which does worry me a bit, as there are other options. It's no longer available in Australia, but many countries still have the XR650L, and many claim it's a superior bike. Is it? Maybe. It depends on your style of riding. In our opinion, the DR650 is a true big bore dual sport bike. The XR650L is more of a big bore dirt bike, while the KLR650 is for highway cruising and smooth dirt roads. Sure, there is plenty of overlap. Some guys modify the Honda and do crazy long road trips. Others like me will modify the hell out of the DR650 and get it close to the Honda for dirt riding. But hopefully this guide should help work out which bike will suit you best. Over to you, Matthew.
Thanks, Barry. So why is the Honda best for off-road riding? It's the lightest by a long shot, it has the best suspension, and the longest travel. Which also means great ground clearance too. A shorter wheelbase makes it very nimble in the dirt. And a wide ratio gearbox gives you a low first gear, and a fifth gear suitable for the highway, although some complain the gaps between certain gears are too wide. Unlike the 17-inch rear wheel on the others, the Honda has an 18-inch rear wheel, giving you a huge variety of tires.
But in stock form, the Honda isn't great for long distance. With no oil cooler, it can run hot when pushed hard for extended periods, and wrecking valves has happened. It has the least oil capacity, smallest fuel tank, and that very high seat height. Also, there's no cush drive hub, so it's not smooth on the road, and the gearbox will probably wear faster with big mileage. The best dual sport bike? We think the DR. It's not great off-road, it's not brilliant on-road, but it's a good compromise, and various mods will help with either. Its weight is in between the other two bikes, as is the fuel tank size. The oil cooler and larger oil capacity work well for long distance riding. First gear is too high for slow dirt riding, but generally fine for dual sport work. The mediocre suspension is okay as long as you are a gentle rider and not overweight. It has the lowest seat height of all three bikes, plus a further lowering option at the rear linkage. The DR's main drawbacks on the highway compared to the KLR are the lack of fairing, a hard narrow seat, and the small fuel tank. Your thoughts on the KLR, Robotic Matthew?
It ain't much fun off-road, Barry. It's the heaviest by far, the suspension wallows if pushed hard, and there are big repair bills if you crash and damage the fairing. But the weight makes it stable on the highway and smooth dirt roads. You'll love the fairing, especially in poor weather. Your ass will love that comfy seat, as will any pillion passengers. You even get a rear rack. Plus it's water cooled, which is great if pulling high speeds for hours on end.
Okay, a quick look at known issues. While all three bikes have great reputations for reliability, a few issues can stick out for long-term owners. The Honda, CDI modules tend to burn out easily, carry a spare. Lean jetting and no oil cooler have seen riders blow valves, rejet and fit an oil cooler. And no cush drive hub can lead to premature countershaft spline wearing and the transmission too. Fit a cush hub if doing long distance. Apparently the DR rear wheel is easy to adapt. Known issues with the DR, Matthew?
There's a small chance the NSU bolts can work loose and destroy the gearbox. The countershaft seal can pop out on pre-2013 models, and there's a very small number of third gear failures. See our DR650 known issues vid for more details.
The Kawasaki? The pre-2010 models were known for using excessive oil. A weak weld on the gear shift lever breaks very easily on all year models. Also use stronger subframe bolts if loading up the rear rack. Don't over-tighten the oil drain plug. The thread strips really easily in the engine cases. Most importantly, fix the doohickey problem before it destroys your engine. Very important, pause to read this for more details. There you have it, guys. If you have further tips, let us know in the comments. And if you own one of these beasts, tell us what you like or hate about your bike.
Barry says he has another video coming out soon. He really should stop eating them. Ha ha ha. What a lame joke. Just like this video review. Sigh.